So temperature-dewpoint spread. Well, we know from looking at METARs in the past that we can easily find the temperature and dewpoint listed right in the middle there, and we also know that warm air can hold a lot more water than cooler air. All air has some amount of moisture, some amount of water in it, and the temperature that a particular parcel of air needs to be cooled to for it to become saturated and cause visible moisture to appear is called the dew point, all right? We can watch this parcel of air form into a cloud as the temperature is decreased, as the air rises, cools, and the air becomes saturated, we see visible moisture appear. If you want the real technical definition, the dew point is the temperature an air parcel must be cooled at constant pressure and constant water vapor pressure to allow the water vapor in the parcel to condense into water or dew. Basically, the air has to be cooled down to the dew point, and then it becomes totally saturated and we get visible moisture. An example of this is that glass you hold on a warm summer day, full of ice water, and the glass is below the dew point, all right? It's cold. And the air near the glass gets cooled down to the dew point or below it possibly, and that causes the moisture to be pulled out of the air, stick to the glass, and then the glass sweats, so to speak. And that's what we're used to seeing. Now, when this really plays into effect for us as pilots is when we have a temperature and dew point that are close together when we're in the air, and we hear it on an AWOS station such as this.
Sky condition broken 5,000, overcast 6,000. Temperature 0.8 Celsius, dew point 0.7 Celsius.
And as you enter into that area where the temperature and dew point spread is very close together, well, you can expect lots of visible moisture, low ceilings, clouds, fog, low visibility. It looks like this out the window. It's not so fun. When the temperature and dew point spread are far apart, there's a big difference between the temperature and dew point. Well, then you get nice weather like this in the desert where you have great visibility and no clouds, no fog, no visible moisture. Now, when the dew point is below the freezing point, when the dew point is below 32 degrees Fahrenheit, then frost will form. But does it always have to be below 32 degrees Fahrenheit to get ice on your wings or frost? Well, not really. Let's take a look at this example here, where we flew in somewhere, we landed there for dinner, we walked back out to the airplane, it is 39 degrees outside, the dew point is 36 degrees Fahrenheit, so actually above the freezing point, that caused dew to form on the surfaces of the aircraft because the aircraft radiates heat, these flat surfaces radiate heat up. As those flat surfaces radiate the heat, well, they get cooler and they fall below the outside air temperature, below 39 degrees, down below 36 degrees. They start forming dew on them because they cool the air around those cool surfaces and it pulls the moisture out of the air. So now the air is saturated just right at the microenvironment, that little microclimate right up against the skin. That causes the dew to appear on the skin of the airplane. And then the airplane continues to radiate heat. And guess what? It gets below 32 degrees Fahrenheit. And then that dew freezes. And whether or not you call this frost, well, at the end of the day, it's frozen water stuck to your wing in your aircraft. And no matter what, it's a bad day for you as a pilot. You're not going to be going and flying home after dinner after this happens to you. This actually occurred right around 7 p.m., just after dinner time, in the Northeast, in New Jersey, in late November. And your two options now either involve putting the aircraft into a hangar to melt the frozen dew off of it, or waiting until the next day to go fly home. The key takeaways here are this. Temperature and dew point far apart, like in the desert, probably going to be good weather. Temperature and dew point close together, probably not going to be good weather. A number of different types of not good weather could be low ceilings, fog, low visibility in the air, and it also could be frost forming on your wings while the airplane's parked on the ground. And depending on the overall temperature, well, icing could also be a potential, even if the air temperature is above freezing. Remember, our surfaces tend to radiate heat at night once that sun goes down and can wind up below the outside air temperature, causing any sort of liquid moisture that forms on our surface of the aircraft to turn into ice and cause a not good day for us.